Natalie Doran. Good to be here. Thanks again to Bcoin for hosting this, and also to Dobby for the invitation. I hope it's interesting. I'm going to be talking a little bit. Natalie is as well. Short video and any questions after. Okay. So before I explain what our village is, let me ask you a question. What's the most valuable asset you have, other than, where's he gone? Bcoin tokens.
Time.
I guess it gives it away. It's a bit obvious, but it's amazing. In countries, I've presented this in Japan, Malaysia, Indonesia, UK, Switzerland, and it's amazing how most people don't say time. They say their car, their house, their health, their family, their wallet, but they don't say time. So just to put this in perspective, 610,000 hours. That's the average life in hours. That's 70 years old. What's the average life expectancy in Singapore?
82.
You can't say it. He's our head of marketing. He's cheating. 82. 82 at 718,000 hours. That's it, folks. That's your life. Just to make you even more depressed, the real number of hours that you actually have impact on this world is even less. Think about it. Third of the time sleeping, maybe the first 20 years or so of school. So in reality, you've got about 300,000 hours to have an impact on the world. And unfortunately, good old Steve Jobs found this out a little bit too late. As you know, he passed away from cancer. And this is what he said. Favorite things in life don't cost money. The most precious resource we all have is time. So I just want to put this in perspective so you remember that, and hopefully you don't think you've wasted time this evening. So, our village. Our village, quite simply, is a platform. It's a social marketplace on an app where people exchange services, skills, errands, and they get paid in time credits, not money. Okay? Time is the currency. Now let me go through four global issues that we think we solve with our village, and then Natalie will go through the app itself. The first is social inequality. How many ladies in this room? One, two, three, four. Yeah, you look like one, but not. Five, six, six. Social inequality, man, female, rich, poor, educated, uneducated. I have a great car, you don't. I live in a big house in a famous street, you don't. All over the world, right? So, why is our village a social equalizer? Quite simply because regardless of nationality, gender, age, religion, wealth, what else is there? Status, 1 hour, one credit. So whether it's my hour, his hour, Prime Minister Lee's hour, Queen Elizabeth's hour, 60 minutes to 60 minutes. Okay? So bear that in mind. That's an important point. Second one, fractured community. We've been talking to the Singapore government. In fact, we're partnering with the Singapore government to help the fractured communities in some HDB blocks throughout Singapore. Okay? So on this platform, we find ways that people can help each other, share each other's time. Doesn't have to be a professional service. It could be helping next door neighbor carry her shopping. Okay? And by using this app, we find that communities bond together. We're not just talking to Singapore, we're talking to communities in Japan, in Tokyo, and in London to kick off. Third one, aging population. It's a problem everywhere. I just came back from Tokyo last week. Huge problem. It's a huge problem in Singapore, globally. So why does sharing time help the aging population? Well, there have been many studies, one in particular done by London School of Economics in the UK, together with the College of Medicine, which is the Doctors Association. And they surveyed thousands of elderly in the UK who are doing this time sharing experience. I'm reading a book to someone, I'm making a cup of tea for someone else. Whatever that is, and they found out 48% of the elderly said they had a health benefit. Physical health. 72% said they had a mental health benefit. Now you say, so what? Well, the healthier you get, the less sick you are. The less sick you are, the less you go to the hospital. The less you go to the hospital is a big social cost saving. So they actually quantified that through this time sharing, on average, there's a macro saving of $2,000 per year per member. That's huge. Think how much Singapore government is saving. Now finally, misplaced resources. Particularly in corporations, and part of our platform, Natalie will explain a little bit more, is around CSR. Alright? Corporate social responsibility. And we're talking to some of the biggest companies in the world on how our platform can help them place resources they have to people who need this skill. So these are just four, not just, but four major global problems where we think Hourvillage can help. Now, what's our solution? I should pass this
to me. Thank you. Hi, Natalie. So what is the Hourvillage solution? Well, we believe that sharing time, giving time, exchanging time can actually change the world. Not just four global issues, but all of them. And how we do that is that with the right platforms, we can incentivize individuals, corporations, nonprofits, even governments to have sustainable social impact and add value to every user. And so one of those platforms, well, as I mentioned, we have a P2P social marketplace for time exchange. But not only that, we identified a gap in the market for a corporate-focused B2B platform connecting corporate employees and volunteering them and rewarding them with time and with vouchers. The credits that Andy mentioned, 1 hour, one credit, regardless of who you are, links these two platforms together and means that we tackle time exchange from both sides of the market. But to give you a bit more information on time exchange, here's Hourvillage. Spending those hours on things you want to do. So let's say I join Hourvillage, I see a listing for social media training. I decide to give my time to help that user. I gain 3 hours of credit. And then I look through and see these things. Oh, what do I want to receive? Oh, well, I need someone to walk my dog. I need someone to carry my shopping. I actually need some presentation skills. I can then use those hours and exchange those with another user to get that service or skill. I join Hourvillage, I gain 3 credits to start, I search a calendar of opportunities, different time exchange, giving and receiving, I earn credits by giving time, and I spend those credits on the things I want to do. It's a self-governing community. You leave feedback, you rate, people can talk about the experiences that they've had, and then you can also gift those credits you've earned to charities or other users. I mean, how powerful would it be that instead of solving issues with money, we could give charities the gift of time. Time and talent, which is actually what they need. But we don't stop there. In fact, we identified a serious need for corporations to have better CSR and better employee engagement that's led by time and it's led by their own culture. And this is Timefly. It's a B2B platform that connects corporate employees to volunteering opportunities and rewards them with vouchers, experiences, and of course, our time credits to spend in our village. Corporates pay a subscription to Timefly, and their employees download the app. They then see a calendar of volunteering opportunities. Do I want to do pro bono law? Do I want to do reading to the blind? Whatever engages me, whatever I feel that I want to give back to, rather than my boss telling me, this is the program we're doing this year. Then I book in. Two clicks, I'm in. I don't know if anyone here has tried to book volunteering in the past, but it is a logistical nightmare. Spend time, more time actually trying to book it than doing volunteering itself, right? And we need digital innovation in this space. I do my volunteering, and then I unlock a reward. Maybe it's a yoga class, maybe it's a personal training session, something that adds to my company culture and my well-being. All this data is then aggregated into a real-time impact dashboard, where corporations can get a real scope of their culture, how their employees are volunteering, where they're volunteering, is it skills based, is it the C-suite, a real scope of data that they can export for their sustainability reports and for their marketing as well. And this is what it's about. It's about real employee engagement through CSR, enabling people to give back in the way they want to, being able to have learning and development paired with social impact by tailoring it to our village as well. Having a real work-life balance, I mean, we all know that after your work life, your home life, your social life, Netflix, searching on crypto exchanges, yeah, volunteering is somewhere at the bottom of the pyramid. And it is unrealistic to think that we're going to flip someone's day upside down. But what if we could bake giving and CSR into the most important part of your day? Your work life. And having a rewards and incentivization structure that basically encourages people to give whilst incentivizing them on things that help them in their day. So corporations, by paying the subscriptions to Timefly, access a real-time dashboard, and we don't forget the charities either. They are also able to upload opportunities, activities, volunteering events onto our village, onto Timefly. They can see similar insights of corporations. Nobody's been giving charities the kind of insights that corporations have had for hundreds of years. Who are my low-hanging fruit? Who are the people who connect with me the most? We're able to say, the most likely volunteers for you are women in these industry who redeem these kind of rewards. Real insights which make those very small marketing budgets matter, but mean that we have sustained social impact. So here we can review insights, manage and create opportunities. If I'm a corporation and I decide to have my own recycling program, how do I engage my employees to do that? I can do it through Timefly. And of course, analyze.
To me. So each different type of user has a different driver to join. So for an individual, we tested this, the prototype out with hundreds of university students, corporations, NUS, SUSS, Stanchart, Deutsche Bank, FedEx, government employees. We found the biggest driver was having a time resume. Now, people in this room, different backgrounds, different ages, but imagine the millennials who don't have work experience and they're applying for a job. What can they show? 7-Eleven, McDonald's, Starbucks? That's about it. But imagine an 18-year-old has donated 20 hours of time to a blockchain conference, God forbid, and he applies to Bcoin and he says, look, I have an audited, blockchain audited 20 hours I have volunteered for this blockchain conference. That's much more powerful than working for McDonald's or 7-Eleven. So time resume was the biggest driver. The others obviously showing knowledge, a new skill, network, and also your own personal brand. One VC called this Facebook with sharing. Not sure if it's a compliment or not, but it shows this potential. For nonprofits, it's a no-brainer. It's getting more volunteers. It's having a currency to reward volunteers to come and help. And it's also about data insights. who's interested in donating some time to what, where, and when, whether it's domestically in Singapore or globally. So individuals and non-profits. The third category is corporations. And I think Natalie's already explained that. It's all about engagement, tracking, data analytics, and also company culture. We're talking to some very large companies that are completely working with different values throughout the world. Companies that have 100,000, half a million employees, completely fragmented in terms of values. And so Hourvillage brings them together because they donate their time to values they have in common. Finally, government. Government is a way, all governments want their workforce to be, to have better skill sets, but it's also a way of tracking trends. In Jurong West, if there's a big demand for elderly men to clean their apartment, well, that should be telling the local services there's something wrong there. So it's a great way to track and to forecast what's going on. So, where are we now? This is a small example of some of the companies that we've been working with. Microsoft, Syngenta. Syngenta is the biggest agribusiness in the world. Microsoft, 125,000 employees. Syngenta, 28,000. Unilever, I'm sure you know, some of the biggest brands in the world, 170,000 employees. And we work very closely with SUSS, which by nice coincidence is probably one of the leading blockchain universities in Singapore. MVPC is the government. Amokyo Family Service Center, now we're getting to really grassroots, right? Babes, a small charity, and SPCA, cats and dogs. So you can see from one of the biggest technology companies in the world to the biggest agribusiness, biggest FMCG, to the smallest charities. This is a way, what they have in common is time. And we've been fortunate enough to sign a contract with Microsoft. Microsoft love this platform, even though we are a startup. They see this as being a platform similar to GitHub that they acquired for only $7.5 billion, or Glint that they acquired for $400 million, or even LinkedIn. Okay? And so we're working very closely to develop our blockchain capability with Microsoft. And not just Microsoft Singapore, we're talking to Microsoft in Japan and soon in the UK. It's also used as a platform for CSR. Maybe you were going to... No, we're still here. Sorry. So, we thought about this about 3 years ago. To be honest, I thought about this 15 years ago. But there weren't really apps then, blockchain was unheard of, and it took time to really think and develop this concept. But in earnest, in Singapore, we started about 3 years ago. We researched, we spoke to a lot of people, we tested the MVP, and finally we have an app, which you can't download yet, but by the end of this year you will. Not as easy as it looks. So we'll be launching in Singapore, hopefully by Christmas, at the very latest, January 2019. We'll be launching in Tokyo and in London by the end of next year. Personally, I spent 20 years in Tokyo, so I have a small network there. And originally from London, I have quite a good network there. So we'll be launching Singapore, Tokyo, and London. And we'll be introducing AI and blockchain together with Microsoft, if not by the end of next year, probably by 2020. So our plan for expansion is quite aggressive. As you can see there, London, Singapore, Tokyo. We'll focus then on Asia, and then we'll move more Europe, North America, and then Africa, South America, and the rest of the world. We have already interest from Africa. Some countries in Africa see this as an alternative to microfinancing, where we can't relate with this sitting in this wonderful meeting room. But people are borrowing $5, $10, $20. But often it's for services. And those services, probably people in the village nearby can offer them, but why should they help each other? With this, they help each other because they benefit. They get a time credit which they can use for themselves. Remember, 1 hour on credit. So whether you're a farmer in Africa who needs his roof mending, or whether you're a startup in Singapore who needs legal advice, 1 hour on credit. It's the same. 60 minutes, 60 minutes. Okay? So our target, 50 million members with over 1 billion hours exchanged by year five. Okay? We're starting already in Singapore with about 10% of Singapore population through our MOU partners. And we're working with partners throughout the countries we're going to expand. The likelihood will be joint ventures. Some countries where you have a great network, it'll be 100% subsidiary. So the reason we're here today, we're not doing an ICO, sorry to disappoint you. There's no bounty, there's no freebies here. In fact, we want your money. So we're doing an equity round. We've already gone through a seed round last year, and we're raising 5 million Sing dollars into our village, Singapore, and that'll be the holding company for the whole expansion. The plan is 2 to 3 years, IPO or trade sale. I've been very lucky, I've done 5 IPOs. One I took to over $500 million market cap in Tokyo.
I'm sorry to add, so the plan is to build the adoption of our village on the platforms that are already built and already launching, but then work with Microsoft on co-creating those decentralized assets. It's a 3-stage partnership, starting with time stamping, smart contracts, but moving forward into AI, and obviously they're going to be a partner for the corporate platform as well. So it didn't make sense to decentralize from day one, but to build the adoption, build the education, and start building out those assets simultaneously.
Thanks, Matt. So this is our team. I'm the founder and chairman. Our CTO is ex-IBM, Oracle, Tata. Okay, Chad was the chief human resource officer for SGX, Singapore Stock Exchange, and Tiger Air. And we have Natalie, we have here Gerald, who's our head of marketing. We have a team also in New Delhi, who are developing the app. So Singapore and India, and then we will expand. Our advisors are on the right side, you might know some of them. Anson Zeal is chairman of Access, the blockchain association, so we're in good hands there. Hirano-san is his counterpart in Japan, so chairman of the Japan blockchain association. And CEO of a Tokyo Stock Exchange listed IT company. And Jerry Loy will be our representative in the UK, currently an advisor to the UK government. So as you can see, we don't have many hoodies in the team. We're looking for more. In fact, we need younger people, and we're recruiting quite aggressively. So, no airdrops, no bounties, I'm very sorry. But I thank you for your most valuable asset, your time. Thanks very much.